Namaskar, my dear students. Today in the quick review section, we will be discussing a very important topic, that is gingival retraction in fixed partial denture. It is a very important short note which comes in the theory exam. You may also be asked in the viva, especially if there is a retraction cord which is kept in the viva tray or the spotter's tray. Then many MCQs are framed. That also we will discuss. So let's begin. Now, what is gingival retraction? Gingival retraction, also called as the gingival displacement, which is the more appropriate term. It is the deflection of the marginal gingiva away from the tooth. It is also called as tissue dilation. Now, there are two components in the gingival displacement. First is the lateral displacement and second is the apical or the vertical displacement. Now, what the lateral displacement will do? It will displace the tissue laterally so that the finish line that we have prepared of the crown will be accessible and adequate bulk of the impression material can be interfaced with the prepared tooth. And in the apical or the vertical displacement, it can cause trauma to the gingival tissues, which can also be followed by the recession. So we conclude that lateral displacement should be preferred and the apical or the vertical displacement should be avoided. The next question is, why gingival retraction? Why we want to do the gingival displacement? You know, as I told you, it will expose the margins or the finish lines of the prepared tooth, especially the subgingival margins. Okay, and the bulk of the impression material will go around the margin. Ultimately, it will add to the precision of the restoration, the marginal fit of the restoration, and it will prevent any kind of periodontal disease around the area. Now, how to do the gingival displacement? What are the methods? Okay, there are many methods. So let us classify them. The first classification was given by Bachmeier and Williams. He divided the methods into two categories, non-surgical and surgical. In the non-surgical, we have rubber dam and clamps. We have retraction cords. We have retraction rings, copper bands. In the surgical, we have gingivectomy, gingivoplasty. We can do rotary gingival curettage or electrosurgery. Now, the second classification, which is more popular, was given by P.W. Benson. Okay, he classified into four categories, the mechanical method, mechanico-chemical method, rotary gingival curettage, and the electrosurgical methods. So let us discuss the mechanical methods first. Mechanical methods are the oldest methods. Okay, they were first to be developed. What is actually the mechanical method? It is the physical displacement of the gingival tissue. It can be used alone or in conjunction with other methods in combinations that give better results. Some of the mechanical methods are, first is the rubber dam, second is the cotton twills with the zinc oxide eugenol cement, then we have copper band method and we have the retraction rings. In the mechanical methods, first we have the rubber dam. What is a rubber dam? It is a thin sheet of latex that creates a barrier between the working field and the rest of the mouth. Okay, it mainly works on the principle of compression. It produces retraction by compression. Now, in 1864, S.C. Burnham, he introduced rubber dam. This is one of the multiple choice questions which is asked. Coming to the advantages, yes, it helps in the control of seepage and hemorrhage also because it is creating a total barrier. Second, ease of application. But first, you will have to learn the technique of application, then it becomes easy. Disadvantages, full arch models cannot be made, okay, by this method. Second, it can only be used in the preparations with minimal subgingival preparations. Cotton twills with zinc oxide eugenol cement. This is also another mechanical method. In this, we apply gentle pressure over a period of time. So this also works on the principle of compression. What we do in this, we mix the zinc oxide eugenol cement, fast setting cement into a creamy consistency. We take the cotton twills rolled into a mass and a pack is made. This pack is held in the sulcus. Regarding the time, minimum 48 hours, but not more than 7 days, it should be kept. Okay, so what is the main disadvantage of this method? First, there may be sulcular hemorrhage, there may be bleeding during the packing, and second, it is time consuming. It takes time, over a period of time, it will cause the gingival retraction. Second is the copper band impression. It is also the physical means of displacing the gingiva. In this, what we do, first we select a copper band according to the size of the tooth, then the cervical end of the band, it should be trimmed in accordance with the finish line, it should seal properly. Okay, then the band is filled with the impression material. We can use impression waxes, we can use impression compound, elastomeric materials, gutta percha or autopolymerizing resin. Okay, in this, the most common which is used is the impression compound. Then what we do, once we have filled the band, we will seat it on the tooth, then chill the impression, it should cool down, and then the impression is removed. It can be removed with the help of a towel clamp. You know, though this copper band method is a good method to confirm the gingival margins, but as we are putting the or placing the copper band, it may apply some apical pressure. Okay, so the main disadvantage of this method is that it may cause injury to the gingival tissues around the tooth. And second, if excess pressure is applied during placing, then what will happen? It will tend to stipple the tissue from the tooth. Retraction rings. They are the ready-made rings which are available, okay, of various sizes. They produce the mechanical form of gingival displacement. Okay, they are in the form of the gingival retraction collar. They are moved down over a tooth and which causes the displacement of the gingiva. After the mechanical methods, let us discuss the mechanico-chemical methods. In the mechanico-chemical method, we have combined two components, mechanical and the chemical. In the mechanical, it is just the same, that is physical displacement of the gingiva. We are placing a string or a cord into the gingival sulcus to displace the tissues. In the chemical, we are treating the string or the cord with one or more chemical compounds. Okay, now why we are adding this chemical method with it? Because it will cause temporary shrinkage of the tissues first, and second, it will control the hemorrhage and the fluid seepage around the area. So it is giving us the advantage of fluid control also. We will have time for making the impression. Retraction cords. These are the 100% cotton cords or the threads, okay, which cause the retraction of the gingiva. If they are used alone, they will cause physical displacement, that is by the mechanical means. If they are chemically treated, they are soaked in a solution, then they will cause hemostasis also. So that will give us the advantage of fluid control. Okay, coming to the retraction cord designs, they can be twisted, they can be knitted or braided. Okay, now they are designed in such a way that the threads will not separate when they are inserted into the sulcus, and that will become much easier to use. Now comes the diameter of these retraction cords. This is very important. It comes in MCQs also. First, the largest size cord that can be atraumatically placed into the sulcus should be used. Okay, we can't generalize to use this size because we have to see the clinical situation. This is one of the multiple choice question also which is asked. Now the diameter can be divided into three categories: small, medium and large. In the small, it is used for the interior teeth where there is thin, firmly tissue present. Okay, the medium ones are indicated where the great bulk is present in the posterior teeth. And large, it should be used with cautious so that it does not produce the soft tissue trauma. Okay, depending on the thickness, they are color coded also. Like black, it is 000, yellow, 00, purple, 0, blue, 1, green, 2, red, 3. So this is in the increasing order of the thickness. Now we discuss the diameter and the design of the retraction cord. Depending on the surface finish also, the retraction cords can be waxed or unwaxed. In the wax, the retraction cord, it is coated with a wax coating. Okay, that makes it smooth. Second, depending on the chemical treatment, they can be plain or impregnated. Impregnated means they are chemically treated, which will give the advantage of fluid control. So if you get a separate note on retraction cord, you can write all these classifications. Now the question is that which chemicals we can use to treat these retraction cords, okay, so that we get the advantage of fluid control. In this we have three categories. First is the vasoconstrictors. Right from the name, it will restrict the blood supply by decreasing the size of blood capillaries, okay, so it will reduce the seepage. In this we have 0.1 to 0.8% epinephrine. Second category is biologic fluid coagulants. Right from the name, it will coagulate the blood and the tissue fluids locally. Okay, it will create a surface layer and thus decrease the seepage. In this, we have 100% alum solution, potassium aluminium sulfate, 15 to 25% aluminium chloride solution, 13.3% ferric sulfate, 15 to 25% tannic acid solution. You know, these solutions with their percentage is very important, especially when you are solving the multiple choice questions. Third category is surface layer tissue coagulants. Again, from the name, it will coagulate the surface layer. It forms a impermeable film, okay, that will decrease the seepage. In this, we have 8% and 40% zinc chloride solution. You know, commonly we use combinations of one or the other. The common combinations are epinephrine with alum, epinephrine with zinc phenol sulfonate, then 4% epinephrine with alum, 0.1% epinephrine with cocaine, zinc chloride with 8% epinephrine, alum with aluminium chloride. Epinephrine, as we discussed, epinephrine is used in the concentration of 0.1 to 0.8% to saturate the retraction cord. Okay, it is a vasoconstrictor, so it causes local vasoconstriction of the gingival tissue and with minimal systemic effects if it is used in an intact sulcus, mind it. Okay. Now there are certain contraindications for using the epinephrine. Patients with cardiovascular disease, hypertension, diabetes, hyperthyroidism, patients taking Ravulfia, ganglionic blockers or monooxidase inhibitors, these are the antidepressant drugs, hypersensitivity to epinephrine. You know, these contraindications often come as multiple choice questions. Okay, then there are certain systemic reactions to the larger dose of epinephrine, which is called as epinephrine syndrome. In this, there is tachycardia, there is rapid respiration, elevated blood pressure, anxiety, post-operative depression, or nervousness. Epinephrine syndrome is also one of the important multiple choice questions which is asked. If we just quickly summarize all the chemicals that we are using, first we discussed epinephrine 0.1 and 8%. It causes good displacement, minimum tissue loss, good response. Only the disadvantage is systemic reactions, epinephrine syndrome that we discussed. Okay, now alum 100%, it causes minimal tissue loss, extended working time, but it causes less displacement and hemostasis than the epinephrine. Aluminium chloride, minimal tissue loss, it provides good hemostasis, but it may cause local tissue destruction, okay, if the concentrations are more. Then ferric subsulfate, it is called as Monsal solution also. It also causes good displacement, but its pH is low. So it may be corrosive to the tooth structure and the soft tissue. This is one of the disadvantage, important disadvantage. Ferric sulfate, 13.3%, it is commonly used. Then good tissue response, it is compatible with aluminium chloride. It gives good displacement and extended working time. But it is not compatible with epinephrine. The only disadvantage is that it causes tissue discoloration. Okay, it is brownish in color. Then unpleasant taste also. Zinc chloride, good displacement, but it may cause tissue necrosis or permanent tissue injury. Tannic acid, it also has good tissue response, but it causes less displacement as compared to the epinephrine and minimal hemostasis. Then negitol. It also causes good displacement with poor tissue response. It also has a low pH, so it may be corrosive to the teeth. Now we come to the techniques for placing the retraction cords, how to place the retraction cords. In this we have four techniques. First is the single cord technique, second is double cord technique, third is infusion technique of gingival displacement, and the fourth we have every other tooth technique. The first technique is the single cord technique. It is one of the most common used method for gingival displacement. It is indicated when we have to make the impression of 1 to 3 prepared teeth, okay, with healthy gingiva. There should be no signs of inflammation, laceration. It is a very simple and efficient technique to be used. What we do in this, first we select the length of the retraction cord according to the anatomy of the sulcus, okay. Second, regarding the diameter, the largest diameter that can be placed atraumatically into the sulcus should be chosen. Then we make a loop of retraction cord which is formed around the tooth and hold it between the thumb and the forefinger. Okay, we place the cord starting from the mesial surface of the tooth. We place it counterclockwise, another MCQ question. Okay, then we start placing the cord, and when we are placing the cord, then the instrument should be pushed slightly towards the area that we have already placed, that we have tucked in place. Okay, if we do the opposite, if we apply the force directed away from the area that we have packed, it will lead to pull out of the cord, okay, that we have already placed. Okay, the instrument should also be angled towards the root to facilitate the subgingival placement. This is another multiple choice question which is asked, that the instrument is angled towards the root, not towards the gingiva. Okay, then the excess cord at the mesial interproximal area, it is cut down. Then the placement of the distal end of the cord is continued till it overlaps the mesial. Now, once we have done the placement, we will wait for 8 to 10 minutes before removing the cord. Okay, so that enough lateral displacement is achieved. And before removing, the cord is soaked in water. Why? Because if we are removing it dry, it may cause trauma. It may cause tearing of the inner epithelial lining. Okay, and bleeding may also occur. After that, we will gently dry and make the impression. Now this is, we have discussed the placement of the cord, the plain cord. But if we have to use it treated, then what we do? We soak the cord in the medicament of choice. Whatever we have decided, we just blot the excess medicament and then we start placing the cord. Second is the double cord technique. Right from the name itself, double means two cords we will use. First, where we will use this technique, the indications, we will use it when we are making impression of multiple prepared teeth. Second, when the tissue health is compromised. Third, when there is excessive fluid exudates. Fluid control is very important. It can be used routinely also for all impressions. Now, technique, how to use it? We will use a smaller diameter cord placed in the sulcus, as we have discussed before. Then we will choose a second cord, largest diameter that can be placed. It will be placed above the first, as we can see in the picture. Okay, just see the shape of the sulcus. That also, just if you see the picture, you will get memorized that it is a triangular shape. First we will place the smaller cord, above that we will place a larger cord. It is asked in multiple choice questions also. Okay, now once we have placed both the cords, we will wait for 8 to 10 minutes. We will soak in water. We will not remove it dry to avoid any kind of trauma. And then we will remove the large cord. We will not remove the small cord. We will make the impression with the first cord in place. Okay, this is another multiple choice question which is asked. Next is the infusion technique. In this, a special dental infuser is used with ferric sulfate medicament, 15% or 20%. It will place the medicament into the sulcus. First, the retraction cord is packed into the sulcus for 1 to 3 minutes. Then the infuser is used with a burnishing motion in the sulcus, circumferentially 360 degree around. Okay, thus the lateral displacement is achieved. The fourth technique is the every other tooth technique. Right from the name, every other tooth means alternate tooth. We will not place the cord in each and every tooth. It is mainly indicated when multiple interior teeth are prepared and we have to make the impression. And the placing the cords around all the teeth simultaneously is not possible. It may cause trauma, it may cause strangulation of the gingival papilla, and it will damage the gingival tissues. So there we use the every other tooth technique. Now we have discussed the mechanico-chemical methods. Let us discuss the rotary gingival curettage. Rotary gingival curettage. It is also called by the name like gingitage, dentage, or truffing technique. What is the purpose of this technique? That we want limited removal of the epithelial tissue in the sulcus. Okay, while a chamfer finish line is created. So that will give us access to the finish line. What is the criteria where we will do the rotary curettage? First, there should be healthy and inflammation-free tissue. Okay, the gingiva around should be healthy. Second, there should be no bleeding on probing. Third, the sulcus depth should be less than 3 mm. And fourth, there should be presence of adequate keratinized gingiva. Then only we can go for the removal. Now the technique, how we will do the gingival curettage. First, we will prepare a shoulder finish line at the gingival crest. Okay, then we use a torpedo diamond. Okay, we will extend this finish line apically 1/2 to 2/3 of the depth of the sulcus, as we can see in the picture. Then we place the aluminium chloride impregnated retraction cord. We remove the cord after 4 to 8 minutes, then dry it and we make the impression. The main disadvantage of the rotary gingival curettage method is that it is an uncontrolled procedure. So it may cause overextension and it may cause excessive bleeding also. Now last we have the electrosurgical methods. Electrosurgical methods. It is also called as the truffing and the gingival dilation method. Okay, why truffing? Because we are creating a trough here also, like rotary curettage. But what is the difference in this? The trough is extended from the crestal height of the gingiva to a point 0.3 to 0.4 mm apical to the finish line. That means a controlled work is going on. Okay, and we will use fully rectified current. This is one of the multiple choice question which is used. Okay, what is the mechanism of action of this electrosurgical method? That first, it causes a controlled tissue destruction. You know, the disadvantage of the gingival curettage is overcome here. It is controlled. How it is done? Current will flow through a small cutting electrode, which will produce high current density and there will be a rapid temperature rise. Okay, and the cells which will come in direct contact, direct adjacent to the electrode, will be destroyed due to the temperature rise. So a trough will be created. Now, what are the indications of these electrosurgical methods? Okay, where we can use? The first is where there are areas of inflammation and granulation tissue around the tooth. So this is the best method. In cases where it is impossible to retract the gingiva, we cannot use the retraction cords. Then to enlarge the sulcus and control the hemorrhage, that means fluid control also there. To remove the irritated tissue, okay, that may have proliferated over the finish line. Okay, so that can also be corrected. To certain extent, we can do crown lengthening also with these electrosurgical methods. But what are the contraindications where we cannot use? First, patients with cardiac pacemakers, TENS, insulin pump. Second, the conditions where there is delayed healing, like debilitating diseases, radiation therapy. Okay, now these indications and contraindications are very commonly asked in the multiple choice question and in the Viva also. Now there are some technical considerations when we are doing the electrosurgical methods, and these considerations are very important. Each and every point can come as multiple choice question. Okay, so let us start with the type of electrodes. As we can see in the picture, it can be coagulating. B is the diamond loop, then round loop, small straight, small loop. These all are the types of the electrodes which are used in the electrosurgical method. Coming to the technique, the first thing that we have to keep in mind is that keep electrode in motion. Electrode will always be in motion near about 7 millimeter per second. It will not be fixed at one point. Second, there should be appropriate current setting. As we discussed, fully rectified current should be used. Larger the electrode, greater the current should be required. Then 5 to 10 seconds pause should be there between the applications. Okay, so this also comes as multiple choice question. Patient should be properly grounded. Very important. The grounding electrode is placed under the thigh. Okay, it is avoided in the back region as it may cause burn. Okay, so this is another multiple choice question which is asked. The tissues must be moist, they should not be dry, and the electrode should not touch any metallic restorations. So these all points are very important and they come as multiple choice questions. Now you may get a separate short note also just on the electrosurgical method. There you will have to write down everything. Okay, now coming to the advantages and the disadvantages. The advantages, it will provide us with a clear operating area without any bleeding. Then there will be healing by primary intention. There will be lack of pressure to incise the tissues. There will be electroplaning of the tissue side by side. Less tissue loss will be there after healing. Coming to the disadvantages, there is an unpleasant odor with it. Okay, then slight loss of crestal bone may occur. Burn mark on the root surface may also occur, and it is not suitable for the thin gingiva. Its main disadvantages are because this method is technique sensitive. Now let us discuss some recent techniques which are being added for the gingival retraction. In this, first are the lasers. Lasers are becoming very popular. You get questions also on lasers. The lasers which cause gingival retraction are neodymium YAG lasers. Okay, you can add this in your short note also to get those extra marks. Then the advantage of laser is it provides bloodless, painless incision. There is a very controlled tissue removal and there is rapid healing. The disadvantage is that it is a slow technique and it is very expensive also as compared to the conventional techniques of retraction. Now there is another technique which has been added recently and it is very popular nowadays. It causes the retraction by dilatation of the gingival sulcus. Okay, first is the gingiform paste. It is a two-paste system. The base paste contains the polydimethyl siloxane and the catalyst paste contains the tin. When we mix this base and the catalyst, it forms hydrogen gas. Okay, this leads to the formation of a foam within the gingival sulcus and it causes retraction of the gingiva. Then second is the paste of aluminium chloride kaolin with water. It is delivered using a gun into the gingival sulcus. Again, it will cause dilatation of the gingival sulcus and the gingival displacement will occur. So that's all for today, my dear students. I'm sure this video will really help you to prepare this topic well. Do not forget to like and share the video. You can give your topics in the comments section. I will try to cover them. Subscribe the channel if you are still new. Wish you success today and always.